Black History Month, Charles H. Flowers High School in Prince George's County hosts a show of its students' art. Part of the process involves students with disabilities attending museums and interpreting art prior to creating their own. LeAnn Holden-Martin, a special education teacher at the school, tells us more.
I teach students with severe cognitive disabilities in the Community Reference Instruction Program, or CRI. This program includes academic instruction and equips our students with life skills to help them transition from high school to adulthood. I feel it is very important to teach my students about Black history. I try to keep the lessons relevant to their lives, making sure I include things the students can see, touch, smell, and hear. I use pictures, videos, and movies to connect the past to their lives, discussing how some things have changed and how some have stayed the same. For example, I show the animated movie My Friend Martin to talk about how Black lives have changed from the past to the present. Together, we have displayed my students' own art in What We See, African American Art Through the Eyes of High School Students with Special Needs. This exhibit is the result of months of work from our students and staff, beginning with visits to local art museums in the community to see different kinds of African American art. One of our visits was to the Prince George's African American Museum, where we were able to see homemade quilts, wood carvings, art depicting the Black Lives Matter movement, and more. After our visits, our next step was to engage with African American artists from Maryland. I met with six artists who each loaned me a piece of their artwork to bring into the classroom. Over the next few weeks, I led many discussions with students about how each art piece made them feel: warm, cold, happy, sad. Afterwards, my students selected a piece of art and began creating their own art. Artist Torian Washington visited my class and talked about his paintings. Students interpreted his work, and some used that inspiration to create their own original pieces. In these pieces, the students reflected what Washington's art meant to them. Some students created pictures and paintings by looking at the painting. A couple of students created an art piece using fabric and tissue paper that allowed them to touch their finished artwork. One of my students, Kaylin, is nonverbal. She communicates mainly by sounds and touching. She pointed to Washington's piece, Home, Mama, a large colorful painting of an African woman. Using markers and guiding her hand, Kaylin outlined the woman. I then taught Kaylin how to use cut squares of tissue paper to fill in her picture. We used many different colors to create the pattern in the woman's dress. All the while, Kaylin would be touching the painting. Another one of my students, Anthony, is in a wheelchair and has limited mobility in his hands and limited verbal skills. He picked Abstract Lady by Karen Johnson Wyatt, a large abstract piece of a woman playing the bass. With tools to help Anthony hold a paint sponge, he was able to spread paint all over the canvas. I moved the canvas to allow him to put paint all over it. He selected different colors, and together we selected what areas to paint. After many days, Anthony completed his abstract painting. These are two stories of how my students were able to create their own pieces and interpret the work of African American artists from Maryland. Living at the intersection of Blackness and disability means that many of my students have spent years falling through the cracks before they reach my classroom. But I know how talented my students are, and they deserve the effort that it takes to help them shine, whether it's working with our assistant technology staff to create innovative art tools, emphasizing tissue paper for a tactile student, or utilizing colored bottle caps for students unable to paint. Throughout this process, I have been inspired by watching them work with art that so beautifully reflects the diversity of Black life.
This program is supported by a grant from Maryland Humanities. Learn more about Charles H. Flowers High School at pgcps.org/Charles H. Flowers. Maryland Humanities is a statewide nonprofit that creates and supports educational experiences in the humanities that inspire all Marylanders to embrace lifelong learning, exchange ideas openly, and enrich their communities. Humanities Connection is produced by Maryland Humanities for WYPR. For Maryland Humanities, I'm Phoebe Stein.